And now, the Joe Bev Experience.
Texas skies, yeah, they'll make you sing.
Today, Austin, Texas is known as the live music capital of the world, with more than 60 venues just on East 6th Street alone. Artists such as Willie Nelson, Lyle Lovett, and Janis Joplin all got their start in Austin. 2003 marked the 70th anniversary of the place that helped launch the Austin music scene. Hi, I'm Joe Bevilacqua. Welcome to From Moonshine to Armadillos, the birth of the Austin music scene. Join me for the next hour as we explore the history of Austin music and two of the men who helped make it happen, Kenneth Threadgill and Eddie Wilson.
Where bar stools are turning to thrones, they made you feel like a king. And seeing all them people smile when you started to sing.
John Kenneth Threadgill was born September 12th, 1909, and grew up singing in his father's Nazarene church.
I stood up on that platform and sung those songs. Had the songbook in my hand because everybody else did. I had it upside down, but I had that songbook there and I knew all the songs anyway. So that's how I got started singing in public.
His Austin High School senior yearbook in 1928, proclaimed Kenneth's motto, "The secret of happiness is not doing what one likes, but in liking what one has to do." While an usher at Lowe's State Theater in Houston, he heard the blue yodeler, Jimmy Rogers.
While he was yodeling, I was seeing if I could gargle out one myself, and then I realized I could do it.
The encounter changed Kenneth Threadgill's life. In 1929, Kenneth married Mildred Greer. He worked at various jobs until in 1933, he opened a filling station just outside the city limits. Claude Matthews interviewed Threadgill in 1982 for a University of Texas film project. He said that during Prohibition, he sold gas out of the front door and bootleg whiskey out of the back.
It was just a gas service station, had living quarters in the back. We sold gasoline, tar, tubes, and I had a little line of groceries in there. Everybody had homebrew if it wanted, you know. I sold a many a 16-ounce Clicquot Club ginger ale bottle of homebrew for a dime.
Rockabilly legend Ray Campy first moved to Austin in 1942. He describes what the inside of Threadgill's looked like.
It was barely decorated. It had a few beer signs on the wall, and it had a bar, and I think it had a cement floor and a few old tables and chairs. It was very simply furnished. It wasn't a nightclub. It was really a gas station, and Kenneth sold some bottled beer, and he had a container there, you know, with bottled beer. And
when Prohibition ended, Kenneth Threadgill got the first beer license in Travis County, and the filling station turned beer joint soon attracted the likes of Hank Williams and Lefty Frizzell on their way in and out of town. Threadgill himself would sometimes step out from behind the bar, his apron still on, and sing.
Any old time you want to come back home, just drop me a line and say no more you're wrong. You had your chance to play the game fair. When you left me, sweetheart, you only left a load of care. And all that you're down.
The outbreak of World War II put a damper on the music scene in Austin and at Threadgill's, and Kenneth worked for the Corps of Engineers on jobs important enough to defer his 1A draft status and keep him out of the
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.